Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in by Michael from Kansas City. Now, Michael wants to build these cool stacked floating column charts over here. And what this is saying, like this section down here in the red, is saying that the first quartile ranged from this low of 11.46 up to the third quartile of 14.5. All right, so that's the data that he has. Wants to try and create this chart. Let's figure out if we can pull that off. I'm going to build some formulas down here, and actually I've already put the formulas in, just changed the color. And the way I think about this is there's an invisible series that I'm going to go ahead and chart, and then how tall the pink, yellow, green, and blue series need to be. So the invisible series, well, that's pretty easy. That's just the low value. And then for the first series, the pink series, the first series we're going to see, it's the delta between the low and the third quartile. And similar formulas throughout, how to build these one at a time, and then copy them over. Okay, now let's build a chart from that whole series. So we'll go to Insert, Column, choose the 3D column chart. Now we need to change this so that way we have the different colors over here in the legend and the years going across the bottom. All right, now that we've done that, we want to choose that invisible series. So I come here to the Layout tab and choose Series Invisible. Now that that's selected, I can press Control 1 or Format Selection here. We'll change the shape, the fill to no fill, and the border color to no line. Click Close. And what you'll see now is that we've managed to make those columns float. Very cool, right? From here, we could go through and choose the additional series, so Series Pink, and format that, change the fill color to a solid fill, and choose a nice pink color. Click Close, and then Series Green, or Series Yellow. All right, now, you know, rather than go into the Format dialog box, we can just use the Paint bucket here and choose Yellow. Don't like that yellow. Well, we're going to be stuck with that yellow. And then choose Series Green and Blue, and so on. All right, so now that we have the chart kind of doing what we want it to do, we have to fix up the legend over here. So I take these words and, you know, just put bottom quartile, third quartile, second quartile, and top quartile. All right, so everything's good except for where we have the word invisible. Now, if I put a space there, that will solve the problem because the color of the column goes away. If I did not want to put a space there, I could also click once to select the legend, click a second time to select that one individual item, and then just click delete and get rid of it. So a couple of different ways to go. Now, this all works out provided your numbers are positive. Once the numbers become negative, then it becomes a whole different ballgame. So depending on their performance, like if it's investment results, we're going to have some problems there. But kind of a cool way to go, interesting looking chart. You know, I understand some people say 3D charts are a lot of chart junk. Your call whether you want to use those or not. But today, talking about how to create the invisible series down at the bottom to have your columns float. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.